Hello everyone, and welcome to Java Forever course. Today's topic is difference between script and program. You will hear these three words and you will need to understand the comparison between these three. One is what we call it script versus a program. Second is I'll call it interpreter versus compiler, right? And most importantly, JavaScript versus Java, right? Just because name word Java appears in this side does not mean these two are same programming language. In fact, these two are totally different programming language. Java is not a subset of JavaScript, or JavaScript is not a subset of Java. Now, having said that, Java is a scripting language, JavaScript is a scripting language, whereas Java is a programming language. The difference is a script is interpreted, whereas a program is compiled. So in order to understand the difference between interpreter and compiler, let's see how usually a code works. When you write your code in any programming language, this is your code, and you write it, let me change the color here. And when you write it to a machine, this is your machine. Let's say this is a Windows machine, and you give it to a machine. This machine understands machine language. Yeah. Now code, when you give this code, your Java code or JavaScript code has to be given to machine to execute it. But then machine do not understand it. So you need some sort of conversion or translation between your code to machine language. We need that. Now, let's take an example. There are two ways we can do that. Let's say that we have a recipe written in ancient Sanskrit language, right? Sanskrit is one of the oldest languages. Assuming that it is written in Sanskrit and you or me do not understand it. There are two ways we can use this recipe. Either somebody translates that Sanskrit recipe to an English recipe and then give it to us. And then we can understand it. That is what we call it compilation. We take this, create an intermediate version of a recipe, and then that becomes our, then we can, the machine can understand it. And this, the compiler usually creates a compiled version of your code. So let's call this as compiled version, right, of your code, and that is fed into the machine language. Now the power of compiled version of the code is it is optimized for the native machines. So if you are creating it for Windows, the compiled version will look different. If you're creating it for Ubuntu, then it will be different. And that is why the compiler for Java, Java is a bad example actually, because Java works a little differently, and I'm giving you a simplified view. In fact, there is and one more layer here in case of Java, which I had taught in the last class. There is one more version here at this point of time that we create a intermediate language in case of Java. But right now, I just wanted to give you a high level of difference between compilation and interpreter. Now, coming back to what is interpreter. In the case of interpreter, think that one of your friend who understands Sanskrit, he's sitting next to you, and he's translating that as you do, like line by line. He tells you to do this. The recipe is not converted into English. He's doing it on the fly, sitting next to you and telling you, do this, do this, do this. That means you're directly executing it, right? There is no intermediate version of the code. That is what we call it interpretation. Now, interpreted languages are little bit faster compared to compiled version, but nowadays even some of the, like JavaScript has an interpreter, Java has a compiler, but then some programming languages like Python can have both interpreter and compiler, right? Because it can run on the fly, and at the same time you can also create a compiled version and optimize it for your machine language. So that's all on this topic. Let me know if you have any question. I will be happy to answer. Post your question in the discussion. Thank you very much.